First, I will listen to you, your questions, sharings, doubts, then lead you into process. Anybody has anything to share, ask, talk, please pick up the mic. See, actually when you go back, the world will not react to you as it was reacting earlier. It will react to you the new way, because you are going with new vibes. You will attract new tribes. I am really telling you, please understand. No, you can talk to people who are following me for years. They all say, suddenly our friend circle, family, everything is now new. we are not able to relate with old people anymore. And everything has become new. Everything is evolving new.
What do you do with yoga? I hate yoga.
The yoga which is taught here. Yeah. Yoga which is taught here. Practice that.
Just take, whatever is fine, just take.
Yes.
Yes,
yes. Every day it is live. You can enjoy. Two times it is live every day. Morning 5, evening 5. You can enjoy anyone live sessions. Not only that, and I am also sitting and spending little time on translating and giving them constantly the new material from the original Agamas, which we are collecting. You see, we have collected almost 3 TB material, 3 terabyte. And only 1 terabyte we have uploaded in the Hinduism Now website. The remaining 2 terabyte cleaning up work is going on. I am sitting and guiding them. So you may learn new cleansing kriyas, all that freely in Nityananda TV. I tell you everything we collected, we will make sure we translate in English and upload it in the internet for anybody to read and study freely. I am very clear, knowledge is free. Only when you want to experience and come here, I ask you to pay something so that I can keep this Sangha running. I can keep this organization running. I can contribute more and more. Ultimately, even if you, whatever you give, I do my labor, I put my labor on it and make it and give it back to society only. So if you give me 100 rupees, I'll put my labor and energy into it. I'll make it into 1000 rupees and give it back to society. And you giving money is only more responsibility for me. It is not more pleasure, it's more work. Yes.
Yes, Swamiji, thank you for the intervention this morning. Mm. It was just what I needed to hear.
Mm-hmm.
Because I realized that deep down there has been doubts inside me.
Mm-hmm.
Having heard from my brother, who siddhis are here to distract you and keep you in maya. And the same message comes from the guru that you were referring to, I've been following. So here I was, No, I've been a bit confused. So it was exactly what I needed as clarity in my mind.
Hateful. But see, our guys who are manifesting the powers, how they become more and more and more joyful, free. And when you guys manifest, the more and more confidence and the oneness grows in you.
Yeah. Exactly what the guru was saying at one time. He said he used to teach certain practices, which he stopped because people seemed to be getting crazy.
No. He was teaching through a wrong system.
Okay. So he stopped certain practices.
So the system he learned is from cookbook. Tell him, Barnes and Noble does not make enlightened being. Understand?
Yeah.
Barnes and Noble may make a noble man. No disrespect. A simple, straightforward truth. To make an enlightened man, it takes little more. Understand?
Yes.
So, see the effects of manifestation of power here. Nowhere, nobody moves away from oneness. They only get more and more grounded on oneness. More and more completion. More and more oneness. More and more enlightenment. More and more expression of Nirvikalpa Samadhi. So the very context is different.
Yeah,
unfortunately, true. Too many people are popularizing Patanjali without touching Sadashiva. And they forget Patanjali is the disciple of Sadashiva. He did tapas to achieve Sadashiva's darshan. He was born and brought up in a place called Chidambaram in Tamil Nadu. That is where he lived and had darshan of Sadashiva. His original works are still preserved there in the original palm leaves, which he wrote, all still preserved in the temple, still available, now gold coated. It is even available for public display once a year. And those Brahmins, they are called the Chidambaram Brahmins. Those Brahmins are only the copyright holders of Patanjali's major three work. Patanjali has done major three work. Panini Mahabhashya and one Ayurvedic work and one this Yoga Sutra. These are the three major works of Patanjali. All three are still available. In that whole tradition, the way the structuring is done, siddhis manifest before you reach enlightenment. But ours is not. Ours, I trigger the consciousness inside you. The more the consciousness manifests, oneness manifests, the more manifestation of powers. There's from outside to in, yes, from inside to out. The only thing, this needs a master who has mastered the science. That does not need a living chain. I am not commenting on whether that person is enlightened or not, all that. I don't want to comment on all that. You understand? What he is teaching, that tradition is different. This tradition is different. There ends matter. Really, Krishna is the greatest exponent of leelas and this extraordinary powers.
Exactly.
If they are not living like Krishna, I think
something missing.
Yes. You said it.
Yeah. Swamiji, to one more question on that. Like for me, I don't know, perhaps for other people as well. I'm not able to experience the oneness to manifest the power. So which
That I commit with you. I'll break the coconut.
Thank you.
I am breaking it.
Thank you.
Many coconuts are broken. I'll break it.
Thank you.
And now, because of this clarity, you will allow the breaking easily.
Yeah, I know.
This resistance was also one reason
why
you guys were not allowing some of the
yes
manifestation.
Yes.
Now it will be done.
Thank you.